my channel, I thought today would be a really good day to make a challenge video. I've seen a lot of challenges on sewing an entire doll outfit, but then I thought, no, that would be too easy. I've already sewn a lot of entire doll outfits, so I thought I'd step it up a notch. I am going to sew an entire doll outfit without a pattern. So before we get started, if you guys would like to see a video of me showing you guys all my sewn doll items and clothing, I would love to make a video of that, and it'll probably be coming up soon. So I have my doll Grace here, and I undressed her so that any bulky clothing items won't get in the way of measurements, since I'm doing this without a pattern. And I think the idea that I'm going to go with is I am going to attempt to do a sweetheart neckline dress. So I'm not going to make shoes because I don't know how to make doll shoes. So I'm just going to be making the outfit itself, and I'm going to go easy on myself and make a dress. This is the fabric I chose, and now I'm going to move on to measuring Grace and cutting out all the pieces I need to make a nice dress. I'm going to start by taking a piece of fabric that I will then cut into the bodice of the dress. And what I'm going to do to measure it is inside out, I'm going to wrap it around Grace's body, leaving a little bit of seam allowance so that it won't sew on too tight, and then a little more seam allowance so that I can add Velcro. And then with a pencil, I'm just going to mark it lightly. Sorry, you guys can't see that very well. And then I'm going to cut the length of my bodice, which I want to be about here, above her waist, right here. And then after that, I will cut the sweetheart neckline. I've now cut my piece for the bodice, and it's just kind of a rectangle with a little heart kind of shape at the top, and it fits around them kind of like a tube top, and it looks really cute like this. So now I am going to cut the skirt out of more fabric, and you want this to be a rectangle, and the length will be however long you want it on your doll. I think I want mine just about at the knees, and your width, it doesn't really matter how wide it will be as long as it's wide, much wider than their waist, because you want it to be able to ruffle it a little bit and still be able to add Velcro. These are the two pieces that I have cut out. This one will be the skirt, and as you can see, it's a lot wider than her waist. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hand stitch a running stitch across the top so that I can then cinch it to be the length of the bodice so that the two will match up nicely. The next thing you are going to do is you are going to lay your bodice piece out like this. And you also want to make sure that you did not tie a knot at the end of your skirt piece. And what you are going to do is cinch it up by pulling this thread that's left open. And by pulling it, you can cinch up your skirt like a drawstring pouch. And then after you have done that, you are going to spread it out a little bit and lay the colorful sides down together on each other with the two sides that will become seams laying down beside each other. Now what you are going to do is you are going to cinch your skirt just a little bit and arrange your new ruffles to where you want them to be. Uncinch it to where the seams will now match up, and this will be your new skirt piece. After your skirt piece and your bodice piece are neatly matched up, I'm going to take pins and pin the two pieces together so that they do not move around when you take this to a sewing machine or hand sew it to put these pieces together. So I am now just pinning this piece together, and I'm going to take this to my sewing machine and sew it together. Welcome to my sewing machine. This is where I will be sewing my two skirt pieces, not two skirt pieces, but two pieces together. Now that you have sewn the two pieces together, you can clip the extra threads off of the sides, and you do want to make sure
that when you were sewing the two pieces together, you sewed below the hand stitching parts because you don't want those to be visible in the final dress. So now what I'm just going to do is I'm going to pull the string right out. And now when you unfold it, you should have what resembles an unfolded dress with nice ruffles. Final step that I did was I sewed down the back seam, just a simple seam on my sewing machine. And since my fabric's pretty stretchy, I didn't feel like I needed to add Velcro. But if you are using a non-stretchy material like cotton, you definitely will want to add Velcro. And I'm sure there are videos on that all over YouTube. But I didn't feel like I needed to since I use jersey fabric, which is quite stretchy. So now I am going to show you the final reveal of my sweetheart dress without a pattern. And here is the final result to my challenge. I love this dress so much. It looks so good and fits really well. And I love the color on Grace. I just really adore this dress, and I'm really proud of myself for making it without a pattern 100%. It has a really nice sweetheart neckline with no straps, and then it has a just below knee skirt with a really nice ruffle to it. I just love this dress so much, and thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you again in the next video. Bye!